This is the collection of spirits that Massimo Viole created because he liked to collect different kinds of spirits. And there are two sections. These are all of the liqueurs. And then there's the section just of whiskies. It's an incredible collection because there's cognacs here, old brandies of Italian production, old Spanish brandies. It's quite remarkable because there are products here that don't exist on the market anymore. I mean, here's a whole selection of cognacs, all in crystal bottles, which just the crystal itself is worth a great deal. These are all of the ceramic bottles of scotch and the different productions of the various scotch producers. And then this is the whiskey bottle collection, which is quite important because there are whiskies here that not even the scotch producers themselves have anymore. And they were all collected, buying them one by one on different trips. Quite an amazing collection. Here's an old friend that I haven't seen for a long time, because this is an example. This is a bottle that was bought in Sacramento by a friend who actually sold it to Massimo Viole. And this is exactly how I got to know this family. Massimo was a collector of these products. This Italian friend came to see me. He bought some of our products and then he sold them to Massimo. When he left California, he asked me, "Now what can I do for you?" And I said to him, "Find me a producer of traditional aceto balsamico." He says that to Massimo Viole. Massimo shows him his acetaia. That's how we started doing business in 1982. This is another example of the rarities that are in this collection. This is a Glenlivet sample bottle, because what this is the label and the bottle that are taken from cask in the distillery. And Massimo had a whole collection of these. This one happens to be the Glenlivet, date of bonding 1963. So this is a scotch that is very, very pale in color because it was just put in wood. Here's another one. This is one that came from Corti Brothers. It's called Spiritus Frumenti, which means the spirit of wheat. This is whiskey, or spirit of grain, actually. This is whiskey which was sold during Prohibition. Notice, for medicinal use. And the pharmacist sold you a bottle of whiskey, but he then had to put on the back the prescription. This one doesn't have it because it didn't come from a pharmacy with the prescription. But notice, it's got this tax stamp of the state of California, cost 10 cents. This was distilled in the spring of 1915, bottled in the fall of 1933. This is another product from Corti Brothers. Coates & Company Plymouth Gin, dry gin, original. And why does it have a monk with a black habit? Because it's in Blackfriars Distillery. They were Benedictines in England, in Plymouth, and this is where the pilgrims left England for the New World after spending a month at the distillery. This is probably from the 60s, but the old label still had the monk on it. This is the kind of place to just lick your chops.
3,500 bottles. It's absolutely breathtaking. Probably not another collection like this in the world.
I have not seen another collection like this, both of whiskies or of Italian spirits. Quite remarkable.